Now I request Professor Srinivasa Varakhedi ji to address the crowd.
Bhavati yatanubhavat edam mukopi vagmi jadamatirapi jantur jayate prajnamolihi sakala vachana cheto devata bharati sa mama vachas nidhattam sannidhim manaseja. Yaddarshanam nikhila dukkham apakaroti chitta prasada vibhavena sukhakaroti. Yatoha madhya sharanam tava deshi kendra Shri Shankararya mama dehi karavalambam. Vedyam virajamanaha Shrimantaha paramashraddheyaha Advayananda Swami Mahabhagaha Ubhayatah parshvayoho Sabham alankratavanto Nagaraja Mahodayavu. Sabham Imam Shobhayanti Acharya Parampara Vidvam Sascha Virajante Bhavatam Sameshan Charanayoho Sabhakti Shraptham Pranamanjali Nivedayu. Bhagavat Padacharyanam Avatarabhumo Tesham eva Siddhantam adhikritya Pravartite asmin vichara satre Dinatrayam vayam vyapayamaha. Aham adau kinchit Gairvana vani maashritya Vaktam ichhami. Prayaha sarve avagachanti iti manne. Kimidam oneness. Ahanto atra prathamavaram asmin vidyapithe asmin kshetre atithirupena samupavishita. The first time I was always host. I'm coming here after 2 years and all of a sudden I was made as guest. Parantu tatra asmin vishaye yada vicharah pravartitah tatra maya tatra oneness anubhutam. Guest host itanayoho bhedah nasti. Saha kevalam nama acharam bhanam vikaro namadhayam mrittiketeva satyam tatra satyam tava dekameva aham asmi itteva tatra aham atithirasmi athava aham atithayosmi iti namadhayam atram vidyate soyam devadatta soyam tasmat oneness maya anubhutam. Atha oneness is not about to, it is not to talk, it is just to experience. What is oneness? I was just wondering, what is oneness? Tatra yadyapi samskrita moola shabdasya ayam anuvadaha. Parantu kasya shabdasya? Kimidam advaita shabdasya va, athava aikya shabdasya, anyasya, kasya shabdasya ayam anuvadaha iti kadachit manasi. Yatha, one, if you take, it is eka, and ness is tva, ekatva. Whether it is ekatva, ekatva manupashita, ekatva shabdastu advaitarthe prayuktaha. Tathapi oneness ityasya kortaha iti kevalam vinodaya, vidvad vinodaya aham kinchit prastota vichhami. Ekatvam, actually this term is used in the sense of number, sankhya. Ekatvam is a sankhya. Sankhya is just apeksha buddhi. If there is no bahutva and ekatva does not have any meaning. So ekatva always is perceived. It's a perception of the mind. Therefore, this is this unit of this larger numbers, ekatva, is not the subject matter of our discussion. So that doesn't have any meaning in this discussion. So if we take the other term, aikyam, so actually it is both are the same. Ekatva or aikya, but aikyam means something else. So it is not just sankhya. So normally, ekatva, this term is used in the sense of sankhya. But aikya is not is used in the sense of sankhya. It is used in different sense. It is a usage, vyavaharayam. Yadyapi ekatva and aikya both have same meaning, but in vyavahara, we don't use it. So, aikyam is used in the sense of a relation. Kayoho aikyam. Aikyam bhavati chet, kayoho aikyam. So, aneki bhutam, eki bhutam bhavati. So, puram anekam, adhuna ekam. Ityasmin arthe aikyam, aiki bhavanam, eki bhavaha, aikyam, iti shabdaha prayujyate. But, what is, whether there were many and they became one. It is not, because we don't understand. But many, how come many become one? So that is the main objection of all Dvaitins. So if you accept there are many, then you can't say one. Because many cannot become one. Simple logic. Therefore, the main objection of Dvaitin is this, that many cannot become one. Therefore, there is no eki bhavana. Eki is impossible. Therefore, we cannot translate this oneness into terms of aikya. So in other terms, we can use the term tadatmya. Tadatmya is relation. So tadatmya, it is, kimuchyate, tadgata asadharana dharmavatvam. If there are two objects, if both share asadharana property, then they are one. So you can say that they have tadatmya relation. But again, the problem is if Deepa and Prakasha and all these we can see. But again, the problem is, again, it is a sambandha. You need a arthadvaya. If there are two things exist, then you can say they relate. And tadatmya accepts this. Inevitably, tadatmya accepts there are two things, maybe in different forms they exist. So this is also not acceptable. So we can elaborate, we can think. The tadatma word is also used in Advaita. And there is another term, a little ahead, abheda. So abheda is also, see, abheda is bhedabhava. So it is a negative term. But we are talking about oneness as a positive term. So we want bhava padartha. We don't want a negative term. So it is not bhedabhava. And therefore, we should go to another term, Advaita. But when Advaita, this is Dvaita Virodhi. But Advaita is not Dvaita Virodhi. Advaitam iti Dvaita Virodhi syat, then Advaita naha kadhapi Dvaita Virodham na kurvanti. Never Advaita Siddhanta rejected the Advaita. No, never. So in that sense, so Advaita in the sense of Dvaita Virodhi is not intended here. So tasmat kenapi shabdin pratipayitum ashakyam kinchit oneness. Atah prayasha, this is sanketa shabda. So, kenapi shabdin nirvaktum ashakyam kinchit oneness iti tattvam atra asma abhichintete. If you start talking about this, we fail. So therefore, we should understand this term by definition, not by translation. Who gives the definition? Oneness is not, it never refers to a principle. If it refers, it doesn't become one. Because oneness is again dvaita. Yataha, yena vyavaharena vayam advaitam jnapayitum icchamaha sa vyavaharaha dvaita purnaha. Sa dvaita bhavati, advaitam api dvaitam bhavati. Yadi shabdena vicharyate, so there is a, Nagaraj ji tempted me to propose some purupaksha here. So actually when you talk about Advaita, then it becomes Dvaita. So if you don't talk, then there is no discussion of Advaita. And what are we doing here? So if we start a discussion, it becomes dvaita. If we don't do any discussion, then maunena sthatavyam. No seminar. So what is the conference on advaita? A conference on oneness. How it is possible? Ataha antato gatva, the term we should understand, brahma satyam. So it is brahma satyam. So nothing advaita, dvaita, or something else. And the wonderful definition given by Brihadaranyaka, I just place before you. Adhikam navachmi, kevalam upasthapaye. Yatra tu dvaitamiva bhavati. Yatra tu dvaitam. I think this defines the scope of this discussion. The entire conference should focus on these two lines. Yatra tu dvaitamiva bhavati, taditara itaram pashyati, itara itaram shrunoti, itara itaram vijanati. Yatra tu sarvam atmaiva abhut, tatra kena kam pashyet, kena kam shrunuyat, kena kam vijaniyat. I think this is the definition of this entire conference. Dvaitam iva and advaitam. Ubhayam api sadhyam. So why I am telling this? Today's theme is oneness, and it never negates, rejects the diversity. That's the beauty of. So Nagaraji, the whole enterprise of Indic Academy is to show the beauty of our Shastras in the modern context. If there is no meaning for these all exercises in the modern context, I would say, let us not do this. But all these exercises have greater meaning in the modern context. That we should understand. So oneness never rejects the diversity. That's very important aspect. And it encompasses the variety. And it gives scope for the variety within itself. This we understand. But in bigger sense, aham tu atra nyaya shastrasya adhyaya chhatraha. I'm a student of nyaya. And I'm a student of dvaita shastra. Then I'm a great purupakshin here. Okay. Swami Advayananji next to me, I'm sitting here. Dvaita and advaita, they go together. They never oppose each other. So the stage itself is an example. So as a nayayika, we always bhedopasakas. We want variety. Sapta padartha nasanti chet koyam prapanchaha. Prapancha se artheva nasti. Prapanchaha nama variety. Satyam brahma nasti chet advaitam nasti. That how to deal with this? So therefore, there is a next level, we should reach that level. I think Indic Academy is trying to do that. So be a nayayika, be a dvaitin. But in India, all shastras have a akhandadriti. This is where we should translate this word akhanda. Oneness is akhanda. It is akhandatva. It is nothing to do with ekatva, advaita, arak. It is akhandatva, akhandadrishti. Nayayikas, whether I am a nayayika or a advaitin, in India, all darshanikas bring one point, that is akhandadrishti. There is no difference in akhandadrishti. So this akhandadrishti, we should bring forward and use it in modern context. So, see, therefore, the vada proposed by Acharya Shankara, Akhanda Artha Vada, which is very important notion in developing this Akhanda Drishti. See, today we are discussing, as you said, politically we have Akhanda Drishti, even economically. So economic development we discuss, but again we have Khanda Drishti. Everywhere we have some sort of perception which makes us separate. We don't have holistic view, holistic perception. This holistic perception comes from this Khanda Drishti. I think this one, why in India now we are facing so many challenges, even global level? Because of our ahankara. So ahankara is khanda drishti. if we go beyond this khandadrishti, we go beyond ahankara, and there we seek akhandadrishti. That akhandadrishti we should achieve. I think that's where all our darshanas help us to really achieve those akhandadrishti. See, today we have so many problems. We want to conquer prakriti. We want to conquer the globe. We want to excel. But why? Because we think that I am the supreme, and everything, rest of the whole world is meant for me, and I can enjoy this, and I am the only person who can enjoy everything. So this drishti, you know, this perception, this is the problem. Not because we don't see the Brahman in prakriti. We don't see the consciousness in prakriti. We don't see sarvam khalvidam brahma. We don't understand. So I am part of the whole. We don't get it. Therefore, all these problems are occurring. Therefore, somewhere through this language of akhandarthavada, through this language of akhanda, we should train our mind in such a way that we should get akhandadrishti naturally. It is all by training. So we should start training our minds. So Indians need this training now. Because for last 200 years, we lost this training. We lost this connection with our shastras. Therefore, we are unable to reach akhandadrishti. This is the starting point to reach that. So lastly, I add only one shloka from Advaita Upadesha. Deha buddhya tu dasoham. If I find myself with the deha, so I am this body and I am Srinivasa Varakhedi, then I should see there is no scope for ahankara. I should be a dasa. Deha buddhya tu dasoham. So I should be a servant. I should be a servant to the prakriti, nature. I cannot use nature. So today we are talking about ecological problems. And jiva buddhya tadam shakaha. If I consider that I myself is a chetana, then I should say that I am part of the whole. I am not everything. I am part of the whole. I should really stake my own stake. I cannot claim everything. Then also I am doing justice to the nature. And atma buddhya tu tamevaham. This drishti. Atma buddhya tu tamevaham. I think Advaita takes us to this journey. This journey is so beautiful journey of oneness. Let us all take this journey of oneness. Thank you very much.